Hey everybody, welcome back to the beautiful golf club here at Superstition Mountain. I want to thank you for watching. I hope you've liked the content I've put out so far, and if you do, please subscribe, and if you like this video, please like it. It helps Google to put it in front of more people so I can help them as well. Now in this video, I want to talk about a question I get asked quite often is, Milo, how do you hit that nice power fade that we see you hitting all the time? So here I'm going to give away my secrets. Now, the power fade, in my opinion, is the best drive in the world. Now, the reason I like it the best is that it's utilizing my swing circle the most efficiently. So when I swing a golf club, basically what I'm doing is I'm making the golf club move in a circle around me. Now, in order to be able to hit a draw, a player needs to shift the circle quite a bit to the right. And much of that's due to the fact that we're hitting some degree up on the ball with a driver, hopefully. Now, there are players out there on tour who do hit down. Many of the men on the tour hit down slightly because they have enough speed that they can still get the ball airborne at the speed that they swing it. Now, most of the general public, we need to be hitting up on it a little bit more. So if we wanted to hit a draw, we're going to have to shift our path quite a lot out to the right. Now my preference is not to have to do that. I like to make the golf swing go around me in a circle that's symmetrical. I don't want to have to shift and tilt it. Now the reason for that is I've done some studies on myself and quite a few of my students, a couple hundred, and have found that players swing 2 to 3 miles an hour faster when they get the golf club moving in a circle around them than they do when they're trying to shift the path to the right and hit a draw. So, if we can get the spin rates where we want them, we're going to actually hit the ball farther with a little fade. Now, the dynamics that need to happen here, in order to hit this little fade, all we have to do is make the same swing that goes around us in a circle as we do with our irons that produces a tight little draw. So if we have a swing with our irons where we're hitting down some amount and we're producing little tiny draws, and we tee this ball up and move it a little more forward, as long as the face is not rotating too much, so if we can keep the face steady and stable through the strike with an upward strike, we're going to get a small cut. So here's a quick little drill for how to learn to do that. So first thing we're going to do, we're going to get the ball forward enough in our stance so it's more or less right in line with the point of our left shoulder. And we're going to feel like the club gets down in front of us here and then works up into the ball. So you're going to feel the club working up into the ball. And you can see when I hit that, that produces just a little gentle fade. Now if I made that exact same golf swing but I caught the ball slightly in the downward part of my swing, you'll see that this ball will start a little to the right and turn left. So with the exact same swing, I hit a draw with different ball position. So again, if we want to hit that little power fade, we want to make sure we're catching the ball slightly in the upswing with a fairly stable release, so not a lot of twist in it, because that'll just produce a pull. But if I can get that face to be stable through the impact zone, whoops, and be hitting up, I'll get that perfect little fade. The keys to creating that nice stable face I've talked about in other videos. If you want to see and learn more about that, visit my website that I'm coming out with, and I'll have some links to that later and show you a little bit of what's going on behind the scenes with my website. But if we want to stabilize this, we have to sequence our swing correctly. Now if we get our golf swing sequenced correctly and we're hitting up slightly, we're naturally going to produce that nice little fade that we see from the top players in the world. You see guys like Dustin Johnson, Rory McIlroy, John Rahm, Colin Morikawa, lots of others. And I'll show you some examples of these players hitting their little cut. And often it looks like they're hitting a fade with the face that looks shut. But that's because the face is super stable and they're hitting up slightly. So here we have some of the best players in the world
all hitting fades off the tee, but these players are not cutting across the golf ball. They have fairly neutral swing directions, but they're able to get the golf ball to fall slightly to the right because they're hitting slightly up. Now, the way that that works is for every degree you're swinging up, you generally are swinging, if you're swinging on a 45 degree angle, you're also swinging slightly to the left at impact. So most of these guys are impacting the ball somewhere around 2 to 5 degrees up, which means that they're swinging 2 to 5 degrees to the left at impact. And if the face is staying fairly stable, you get a ball that just falls to the right. And that's the optimum power fade. And you can see they all do it. It's really well hit. They don't pull the ball. They just hit these bomb fades.
I hope you like this video. If you do and you want to get some more personalized help, come visit me at milolinesgolf.com.
Here we have a behind-the-scenes look into milolinesgolf.com and what it will look like for those who subscribe. You can see we've got everything organized into a step-by-step process to take you from point A to point B and help you to learn systematically, as if you came and took a lesson in person. So if you're interested in more information, visit my website by typing milolinesgolf.com and enter your email address so we can notify you when we're ready for launch.